IUPAC names of elements of atomic number greater than 100. You know, IUPAC means International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry. It proposed some rules to write the for elements whose specific name is not fixed. Why? You know, after discovery of element, its properties to confirm and its preparation to be confirmed, its preparation to confirm, it takes some time. That's why it will be delayed giving specific name for an element after its discovery. So until the specific name is given, it is named from the atomic number using IUPAC rules. So from the atomic number using IUPAC rules, some temporary name will be given until it is given a specific name. So that temporary number, temporary name, how to write? Let's see. So these names, IUPAC names, are written based on atomic numbers. These are given based on Z. Z means atomic number. So for each number, there is some word. If a zero is there in atomic number, we use the word nil. If one is there, uni. If two, bi. For three, tri. For four, quad. Okay. Similarly, for five, pent. For six, hex. For seven, hept. For eight, oct. For nine, n. 10 means 1 0. 1 means n. 1 means uni. 0 means nil. So in that way, from 0 to 9 numbers, some words are given. Nil, uni, bi, tri, quad, pent, hex, hept, oct, n. Now let's see how to write the name of an element having atomic number greater than 100. So first let's see 101, atomic number, its name. Let us start from 101. But 101 is given specific name up to 112, that means up to 112 I think specific names were given already. But here we are learning about how to write names, na? That's why I will start from 101 onwards. So here, see how to write the name. 101, first number in this atomic number, 1. 1 means uni, plus second number nil, plus third number 1, again 1, that means again uni. So at the end, add IUM. At the end of all the numbers, simply add IUM, that is IUPAC rule. So here, to combine all these, so combine these two words. In combining, so remove the last letter of first word. Okay, un. Uni, in uni, I is removed. Okay. Similarly, here also remove I. Then what happens? Already double I is there, na? So its name is now un, nil, un, IUM. Un, anil, aniyam. an nil aniyam, un an nil nil. Here double I is there, no? That's why the first I is ignored. An IUM. An an nil aniyam. Its symbol is from the first word capital U, from the second word small n, from the third word small u. So this is the symbol of element with atomic number 101. Got it. Similarly, for 102, what is the name? An, directly I am writing. Actually, 1 is there, na uni. So ignore I, an. For 0, nil. Okay. For 2, by. IUM. So by UM. Anil by UM. So for this symbol is U and B. U and B. For 103. An nil trium. Anil trium. So U and T. Similarly, for 104, an nil quadium, because 4 is called quad. So quadium, that means U and Q. Similarly, for 5, anil pentium, that means U and P. For 106, U and H. For 6 H na, anil hexium. Similarly, for 107, anil heptium. For 108, anil octium. For 109, anil enium, that means U and E. So elements with the atomic number more than 10 have three letter symbol, but generally elements up to atomic number 100 specific names contain either one letter symbol or two letter symbol. See, for example, what is that? Sulfur, only S we write. For phosphorus, P. For potassium, K. Okay. But for selenium, Se. For sodium, Na. For uranium, U. For thorium, TH. So, in that way, if you take any symbol of element, it contains either one letter or two letters. But these elements with atomic number more than 100 have three letter symbols. Okay, so these are IUPAC names, only temporary names. Until the name of an element after its discovery confirmed, it is named temporarily using this IUPAC name. Okay, so for that, 104 atomic number. Atomic number 104 is reported by both the Soviets and Americans. Americans named as Rutherfordium, RF, whereas Soviets named it as Kurchatovium, KU. Kurchatovium. So both discovered it, 104. So it is in dilemma which symbol to be added to. Symbols to be given to this 104. That's why in that dilemma, first IUPAC name, anil quadium, UNQ. First one name will be given as per atomic number. After that, they go to analysis whether it is first reported by this scientist or this scientist, whose properties are coinciding, who gave the correct information about the element, Based on this all information, name of that specific name of that element will be given. Element name can be given based on the source, based on the scientist by whom it was discovered, based on the properties. In that way, name will be decided. Okay. So, until the specific name is given, the reported element is named, is called by a temporary name using IUPAC rules. Okay. So, finally, RF is given for 104 element, Rutherfordium. Rutherfordium, symbol RF is given to the element with atomic number 104. Okay. So, 109 it is. Next, 112, how to write? Here, 1 means uni. Again, 1 means uni. So, its name is uni plus, again 1, uni plus by plus IUM. Now, what is its final name? Here, remove I. Here also remove I, then here also remove I, then what is the name of this element? An, again an, biuum, anan biuum. So its symbol is UUB, anan biuum. Okay. Similarly, atomic number 115, how to write? So, for this uni pentium, that's why U in from uni, if I is removed, an, from another word uni, if I is removed, an, phi means pent, so at the end IUM, an pentium, so its symbol is UUP. Similarly, what is the name of atomic number 118? So, for this, an octium. Symbol is UUO. An octium. It would be the last member of 7th period. If 7th period is completed, na, it would be the last number, an octium. 7th period ends with the atomic number 118. Okay, right. So, in that way, we write IUPAC names for elements having atomic number greater than 100.